Oh my god, there's a big fat pregnant fly buzzing around the studio and I can't seem to catch it. It's so big. It's like a bomber. Right, so the second video to do with SDCC is going to be the figures that I'm the most excited about that I saw. Not while I was at SDCC, on account of the fact I live in Canada and it's a really far away trip and it costs way too much money. However, I do pay my internet bill, so I was able to look at pictures online. That's too hot to drink. Never mind, putting it back. Okay, so we might as well start with the thing that I'm most excited about. The thing, in my opinion, the company that had the largest, most impressive showing, and that's Mattel, because they brought out a ton of multiverse figures. Just a ton. Night one, previous night, there was a bunch of figures that we'd already seen. And then also, there was an entire wave of Aquaman movie figures that they brought out for us to see in the packaging, so we know they're going to be ready soon. I mean, the movie, you know, it technically, it's going to be released fairly soon in the grand scheme of things, so these figures should be in their finished packaging by now. And the diorama was actually pretty cool, too. They used to display the figures. So Mattel, right out of the gate, had a pretty good showing. But then, as SDCC wore on, there were all kinds of characters, all kinds of figures that a few of them that they revealed later we had seen, but a lot of them we hadn't, and some of them had only ever trickled out in kind of leaked images. But I'm telling you, a lot of these characters we've been just asking for years. Kingdom Come Superman, a redone Batman Beyond figure, a Nightwing figure, a new Starfire figure. There's so many characters, as you can see here, that we've, as fans, been just asking for. And these waves look entirely solid. I mean, just Black Canary, Hawk Girl, John Stewart Green Lantern, Lobo in a scaled down version. I'm so stoked. I'm so excited. And I feel like it's such a rad time to be a collector of DC figures right now, because the multiverse is just killing it. And as well, we've seen pictures like of the prototypes, of the images where they're trying to, they're in their first stages of Red Hood, which is really exciting to me because people have been customizing Red Hood figures for years now, and we've never, ever, ever been given a satisfactory Red Hood figure in the 6-inch scale. Ever. The Signature Series Red Hood, it was like, dude, what are you thinking? Ain't nobody asked for that Red Hood figure almost ever. And then we also got a version of Red Hood in the DC Collectibles in their new 52 figures, but I'm not gonna lie, I have him, I like him, but he's kind of tall and weird and lanky, and he really needs to be changed, but you can't. Well, you can, but it's a lot of work, and I'm not gonna do it. So the fact that they're finally listening and giving us a Red Hood figure, as we've been telling them for ages, this is what we want, it seems like they're finally listening as far as character selection goes. Not to mention, it seems like we're getting a Tim Drake Robin as well. I mean, this is such a wonderful time to be a collector of Mattel action figures. I'm telling you, I'm going to swoop up and I'm going to buy every single one of these figures. And you're going to see it reviewed on this channel because I love them. And hopefully you love them too. The second company I'm most excited about is actually DC Collectibles. Because if you know me at all, you know that I'm a sucker for the DC Essentials and also for the Doomsday Clock figures. I think they look great. Yes, there could be more sculpting detail on these figures. They seem to have tried to slack on the sculpting detail to try and save a bit of money. So I totally get that, because sculpting actually does cost a lot more money. But I'm really excited about them. I think that the color schemes of these figures look great. I've obviously got two Batmans on order, one to keep and then one to redeco as the black and gray with the purple on the inside of the cape. But I'm really stoked about them. And they did show us a few new figures as well for the DC Essentials, that being Joker and Harley Quinn and Burnside Batgirl. They all look fabulous. Joker is probably the one that I'm the least excited about, just because his clothing, weird, like I'm not 100% on board with it, but he still looks fabulous, just not as fabulous as I would have hoped he looked. But I'll be picking him up as well, obviously. And then on top of that, they showed some more animated figures, some characters that animated Batman fans have been asking for, right? They got, there's the Two-Face, and then there's the Scarecrow, there's the Batcycle, there's the robotic face Batman. I'm not really sure what that's all about. I can't remember what episode that's from. But so they showed us some animated stuff. And there's the Justice League animated cartoon show figures. Well, I would totally be into picking all these guys up. I can't because I live in Canada and we don't have the streaming service in Canada. So I won't be able to pick them up unless I buy them off eBay from somebody, which will suck because it'll be expensive. But a man's got to do what a man's got to do. There was some other stuff that I found myself excited about as well at SDCC, but nothing else had quite as large of a showing as Mattel, and nothing else aside from that am I as excited about as I am at DC Collectibles. But, I mean, obviously, you know, Mezco had some cool stuff there. They had the Justice League figures all on display. I'll be picking up all of those. I mean, I have Batman and Superman already, and I'll be picking up the rest, obviously. Mafex had some interesting stuff there. For me, of note, the biggest thing of note is actually that Aquaman figure in his classic goldfish uniform. I know it's not, it's supposed to be scale mail and it's royal armor. I know it's not a goldfish, but it definitely was modeled after a goldfish in the first place. But I was excited about that. And then for SH Figuarts, there nothing really jumped out at me. There was some cool stuff that's, you know, on the screen now, but as for the stuff that I'm going to spend my time in the coming months, in the coming year, hunting down, it's pretty much going to be DC Collectibles and Mezco and Mattel. Those are going to be the three companies that I'm just going completely broke buying their stuff. Does that mean there wasn't other really rad stuff at SDCC that's non-DC related? Of course there was, but this is a DC channel, so I'm not going to talk about that. And then also things that were cool that I'm just not going to hunt down. Cool statues, cool other little doohickeys, doodads, and little figures and stuff. Of course there was, but I'm not going to bother reviewing it because it's not the kind of stuff that I'm going to be chasing down. Things I would have liked to see. I would have loved to see Mattel bring out a Tyler Hoechlin Superman. I think that guy needs to be made into 6-inch scale action figure form. And it also would have been cool if Mezco had have brought out their Batmobile, the one that they teased to us. I think that 1/12 scale Batmobile is going to sell like hotcakes. It is going to sell like fire extinguishers in a burning building. It could be the answer to the 6-inch scale Batmobile conundrum that a lot of us collectors have had for a long time. Yes, the Multiverse Batmobile and the Ultimate Batmobile are very cool. The Ultimate Batmobile is just a little bit big to be 6-inch in scale, but they're not the comic Batmobile. And then a lot of us also have the 1966 Batmobile. You can't really squeeze a DC Universe Classic scale figure in there and have him not look like he's munched into a kiddie ride that you pump a quarter into and then it goes back and forth. It just doesn't look right as far as I'm concerned. They were made for the little skinny spindly legged 1966 Batman figures. And then a lot of us have gone to the extent of customizing other Batmobiles or, you know, getting fill-in Batmobiles. Like for me, most recently, my 6-inch scale, my go-to 6-inch scale Batmobile has become the Night Missions Batmobile. But even that, as cool as it is, won't even pale in comparison to the Mezco version. I think that is going to be just amazing. So I would have liked to see that on display. However, we didn't, so that kind of sucks. And finally, my last thought about something I would have liked to see at SDCC 2018 was I really wanted to see if we could get NECA to drag out that Batman and Superman from their Aliens vs. DC series. And they didn't. And to me, I've lost all hope that we're going to see them. I know before they brought them out, they were like, they're coming out, it's wonderful, and pre-orders and everything. And that means if you have it on pre-order, seriously, go get your money back for your pre-order. You're not going to be able to buy it at retail. Right now, when you're done this video, if you have it on pre-order, Batman vs. Alien, you need to go and get your money back because it will never see the store. This is confirmed online with NECA on Twitter because they don't have the license to sell them at retail. And they were trying to jury-rig something so they could just sell them at least as convention exclusives. And obviously, that has fallen through because they showed them to us a year ago and it's been a year and they're still not at SDCC as a convention exclusive. Maybe we'll see them next year, but honestly, I am not holding my breath for it. I wish we could have made that happen. That Superman had a cloth cape tucked right into his friggin' shirt and it was just probably going to be the coolest Superman figure I've ever seen. And same thing with that Batman. So yeah, it would have been cool if we saw that too, but we didn't see those either. But anyway, that's it. Those are the things that I saw online at SDCC that I thought were the most exciting for me. But I'm sure you have a whole bunch of other things that you've seen online, or maybe you were there and you saw it in person that you're excited about. Hey, maybe I missed something. Let me know down in the comment section below what you're excited about. Maybe what you think I missed. Maybe there's something there that I didn't even see. Let me know down in the comment section below. If you like this video, please take the time to leave a like on it so I know that you liked it. And finally, if you think you'd like to see more of my sort of content, then hit the subscribe button. Remember to ding that bell so that you almost never miss a video. The bell only sometimes works. And then I will see you in the next one. Have an awesome day, super friends, and take care.